ज्ञानांजनशलाका चक्षुर्न्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमः विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिनते नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशकारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासवी गौर। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। मुखम करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपा तमं वंदे श्री गुरुदेव तारं। So I welcome all of you for this the fifth class for Nectar of Instruction, and hopefully we should be able to wrap up our third verse today. We already started with the first quality and the introduction of the third verse, but before we go ahead, we'll quickly recite the third verse. Okay, we're concerned about time, so we'll just recite the third verse. उत्साह निश्चय धैर्यात् तत्तत् कर्म प्रवर्तनात्
तत्तत् कर्म प्रवर्तनात्
संगत्यागासतो वृत्ति
संगत्यागासतो वृत्ति
चद्भिर् भक्ति प्रसिद्ध्यति
चद्भिर्
भक्ति प्रसिद्ध्यति।
There are six principles favorable to the execution of pure devotional service: being enthusiastic, endeavoring with confidence, being patient, acting according to regulative principles such as Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, hearing, chanting, and remembering Krishna, abandoning the association of non-devotees, and following in the footsteps of previous acharyas. These six principles undoubtedly assure the complete success of pure devotional service. So what we covered yesterday was the introduction of this third verse, where Srila Prabhupada is first explaining devotional service, that it is not, and Prabhupada never used to like the word just devotion, and therefore he made it devotional service, because he wanted it to be clear that it's about activity. Okay. So Prabhupada is then explaining, we also discussed yesterday that how actually service is a cultivation, and cultivation of this consciousness of doing our service for the pleasure of Krishna and not getting trapped by the desire to enjoy, the desire to control, in the realm of devotional service. So in any activity we do, we can very easily connect it to our pleasure, very easily connect it to our controllership. Similarly, we need to start connecting it to the service of Lord. And when we try doing that, then it gives a sense of fulfillment, spiritual happiness. And that consciousness, building that consciousness of devotional service, begins with hearing. And we discussed yesterday that hearing is the most important component of our devotional service. We come in devotional life by hearing. We remain in devotional life by hearing. and we perfect our devotional life only by hearing.
Can you please mute everyone? A lot of
So we perfect our life also by hearing. So I had told you, once there was this devotee who was, Prabhupada used to say that, what will your preaching make sense unless you are not hearing? I mean, it's all nonsense. So important for us to hear, because if Shamanam is not proper, the Kirtanam can never be proper. So regularly hearing and reading of Srila Prabhupada books, hearing Srila Prabhupada lectures is very, very important for us. We discussed about that. And the problem is that we either in the conditioned state, and that's what it comes, that meditation means stopping all nonsensical activities, at least for time being. So devotional service puts an end to nonsensical activities, but also engages one in meaningful activities. So it is not just stopping the negative, but negating the negative by cultivating positive. That is devotional service. We negate the negative by cultivating positive. So yesterday, Prabhuji also asked this question of how we can see that some of the other practitioners of yoga systems might be getting some quicker kind of peace and things, low-hanging fruit sometimes. But we need to understand that eventually stopping the negative will not be sufficient, though it may give some respite for time being, but eventually engaging in positive is something which is the nature of the soul, because engagement per se is the nature of the soul. Okay. So it is very important for us to understand that point. And then we discussed how Prahlad Maharaj explains 9 processes of devotional service. Shravanam is being explained, and particularly hearing from Guru is very important. I was telling my kids stories of Srila Prabhupada Lilamrit, and we're just noticing that how Srila Prabhupada was so much interested in hearing from Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, and He was very deeply engaged in his business when he moved to Allahabad to open Prayag Pharmacy. And in that very busy schedule, he found just one day to go to one of the yatras, parikramas, which his Guru Maharaj had taken, Vrindavan Vraj Mandal Parikrama. And he happened to reach Kosi. Okay, Kosi is outside Vrindavan, it comes part of Rajamandal, and there that day the program was that then devotees can go and take darshan of a temple called Sheshashayi Vishnu. Okay, and if devotees want, they can actually hear from Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So many devotees, they left to take darshan of Sheshashayi Vishnu. But very few devotees were, some of them were actually engaged in managing the whole parikrama. They and some other few other devotees only could stay back. And Prabhupada thought that, what will I take darshan of Vishnu? Let me hear from him. So his point was that, imagine one day, one may think this, that, but then let me just sit down and hear from him. And that day, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur lectured for hours together. And slowly, slowly, many devotees started leaving for some services sometime and all those things. But Prabhupada stayed till the end. And then that was noticed by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And he was when His name was proposed by the sannyasi of Allahabad to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And after this parikrama, shortly when Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur visited Allahabad, then he immediately noted that, no, oh, I'll initiate him. He likes to hear. So we see how Prabhupada did such a big wonder actually. Of course, Prabhupada is Prabhupada. But then Prabhupada is also showing as to what we can do in our spiritual life. Emphasize in our spiritual life. And that's what it showed by hearing actually. So often we see that, no, just like if there is a devotional creeper and which has become very big, even if it has become a tree, even then, if water is not supplied to the devotional creeper, which has become a tree, even then that tree may dry down. Okay, the leaves may start drying down. It may take some time. So even if we have spent a lot of years in devotional life, if we stop hearing regularly, stop reading regularly, then the devotional creeper will get dried up. Okay. Even though it may be looking like a tree and eventually fall off. So it's very important for us to hear properly. Then we discussed about enthusiasm, and Prabhupada explains that why enthusiasm is so important. Even in material circles, if one has to be successful, one has to be enthusiastic. And then Srila Prabhupada starts explaining in page 31 page 31 of text 3. In all phases of life, one has to perform devotional activities under the direction of spiritual master. Prabhupada, we can come down. It's down.
Page 31, Prabhu.
Where are they? Yeah, page 31. Yeah, it is down, Roji. We need to come down. Yeah. In all phases of life, where is that? No, Roji, you need to go up.
It's actually on 34th page.
Ah, yeah. In all phases of life, one has to perform devotional activities under the direction of spiritual master in order to attain perfection in bhakti yoga. It is not that one has to confine or narrow one's activities. So this is a very practical essence of this whole page, that since everything belongs to Krishna, it has to be engaged in Krishna's service. Okay, so, and we have to see anything and everything we possess in that light and spirit. We have to try to see it in that way, that how it can be used in Krishna's service. Okay. And then Srila Prabhupada begins to explain about how Krishna is all pervading. And then he explains that how everything is actually coming from Krishna. So it is only possible that by guidance, we will be able to train to use everything properly in connection with Krishna. Okay, so that is it. That's why Prabhupada is again and again emphasizing under the direction of bona fide spiritual master, under the direction of bona fide spiritual master. Okay, because when we see the behavior of the guru, that how he is without attraction and aversion to material world, he is able to engage everything in Lord's service. That gives us confidence and that gives us direction. Okay. So the point is that whatever phase of life one may be in, one has to remain engaged in Krishna's devotional service. Okay. And then in this way, Prabhupada is explaining use giving the example of dictaphone. For example, at present we are using dictaphone. The materialist who invented this machine intended it for businessmen or writers of mundane subject matters. He certainly never thought of using dictaphone in God's service, but we are using this dictaphone to write Krishna conscious literatures. Of course, the manufacturer of dictaphone is wholly within the energy of Krishna. All the parts of instrument, including electronic functions, are made from different combinations and interactions of the five basic types of material energy, namely Bhumi, Jala, Agni, Vayu, and Akash. The inventor used his brain to make this complicated machine, and his brain as well as ingredients were supplied by Krishna. So it has to be used for Krishna's service. That is Yukta Vairagya. It is always possessiveness. Who owns? Naturally, if we understand that Krishna is ultimately owner of everything, which he is, then it becomes easier for us to engage everything in his service. We may be already engaging, but seeing the connection also is very important also. It is not that in general, when we start living life and we may start thinking, why I'm not so enthusiastic, why I'm not so enthusiastic, it becomes very routine, mechanical. It's because sometimes that connection is not seen regularly of whatever we are doing, how it is actually connected to Krishna's service. So it's a meditation, and that's why it is cultivation. So we may go on doing things like outside people may do, but then the difference is that we are able to see the possessiveness of Krishna and thus engaging, apparently same thing, but doing it for Krishna's service. Just like I give that example now of sabji we are making, they are also making. It's not that the process differs, but we are offering it to Lord, considering that these everything is being supplied by the Lord, and we want to offer it to him with love and take whatever he leaves for us to eat. That is his prasad. So similarly, every activity has to be offered to him, has to be done for him. Whether I'm taking care of my wife, whether I'm taking care of my child, whether I'm doing my job, whether I'm doing my preaching, whether I'm doing my chanting, whether I'm doing my hearing. In this way, it's a practice, and this practice has to be done enthusiastically, with patience, with confidence, as mentioned by the previous acharyas, giving up the association of non-devotees and following the regulative principles strictly. Okay. And then Srila Prabhupada explains that no endeavor, this is a very, very important line, endeavor executed with this intelligence. So this is the intelligence. How we see everything as Krishna's possession. Okay, how any activity we are doing, how everything can be engaged in Krishna's service. That is intelligence. Not that only this is possible to be engaged in Krishna's service, not this. So one should not be so like, no. So that's the intelligence, you know. So that when we have that intelligence and we execute our effort to engage things in Krishna service, that is called enthusiasm also. Why do devotees sometimes become less enthusiastic? The lack of enthusiasm happens because of two reasons. When the weeds begin to grow in our heart, you know, all these different weeds are there. Kanaka Kamani Pratishtha, Kutinati, diplomacy, political outlook, and running after fame, running after wealth, running after the benefits which come from devotional service. So when we become too passionate about those different subtle and gross desires, then the weed may start to overshadow our devotional creeper. And that leads to reduction in enthusiasm. And the other could be offense, offensive mentality towards Lord, or as devotees. That is also one. The best way is being introspective and being respectful and being cautious. We can avoid being offensive. Of course, it all again goes back to hearing, because unless we are not hearing, we don't know where we are going wrong, which obviously we will begin to go. So then the fault is not of devotional service. It's not that devotional service has changed in quality. Just like the experience in this world is you pick up something new. It is very exciting, very amazing experience. But then after a few months, you don't enjoy that thing too much. That's not devotional service. Devotional service is as Rupa Goswami says, even greater than Krishna, because it purchases even Krishna. So devotional service is all glorious, no, Bhakti Devi. But the problem is when we allow the weeds to cover our bhakti. So we should be very careful by regularly hearing and being careful of not... by being careful in nurturing our identity of being a servant as a goal in whatever we are doing is something we should be focused on. Now, this activities has to be done enthusiastically. And as we conclude, the execution of devotional service is not a matter of idle meditation, but practical action in the foreground of spiritual life. What if I don't feel enthusiastic? Do I sit down, operate on my weeds and then come back? No, continue in Krishna consciousness. The continuation of Krishna consciousness in itself is a positive samskara. Okay. It increases our faith. It strengthens devotional service. Okay. When we acknowledge that there is something wrong within our heart, but instead of getting depressed in devotional service, I continue with my devotional service, it means the devotional creeper becomes stronger and stronger. And we also become more aware and more careful about why I'm doing what I'm doing. Once I asked Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj, that how do I do things for the pleasure of Krishna? And it was by thinking that this is I'm doing it for the pleasure of Krishna. By thinking. So it's a meditation. While I'm doing any activity, I'm thinking constantly that I'm doing this for the pleasure of Krishna, Guru, Vaishnavas. I'm thinking. So in this way, we will, and this is pure devotional service. It is not that pure devotional service is pure devotional service. Okay. When a devotee does that, he gets pratyaksh, immediate experiences in devotional service, because that's what, it's not something, no, it is something which is natural to the soul. When the soul is thus surrendered to the internal potency of the Lord, then the glimpse of that itself is sufficient to keep the soul happily engaged in devotion. So that's how it is. But while we do this, there will be failures, and there will be, obviously, therefore, we come to the next para. These activities must be executed with patience. So the devotional service which we are discussing about, whatever activity we are doing, thinking, first of all, those activities have to be proper, authorized by Guru. That is of course, if one is a married person, he's taking care of wife, taking care of kids, Vaishnava household, chanting, hearing, reading. So those activities are all bona fide, all part of devotional service. According to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, the karma prayas of grahastha is included in pure devotional service. It's not, we should not think my duties, what I'm doing, this is different devotional services. It is included in devotional service. Okay. Just like if I cook in the kitchen for the Lord, so that is having the same purity as what is being offered in the altar. The deity kitchen is also equally important. Okay. Although we are cooking bhoga over there, the bhoga is eventually going in the altar. Similarly, these all things are ashram is a place where we cultivate spiritual culture. So this is very important. All one has to do is, one has to think while doing all the duties that Krishna is ultimately the owner. And let me do all what I'm supposed to do for the pleasure of Krishna. But then what will happen? There'll be failures. Sometimes somebody will do something, we'll become angry, upset. Or sometimes we will become interested in something else. Sometimes we may forget this. Sometimes something may happen. Sometimes it may so happen that we may not be interested. We may not be so much interested in doing our duties properly. Sometimes something will happen. So all one has to do is one has to continue on this path with patience. So Prabhupada gives an example of a married girl who wants the offspring from her husband, but she cannot expect that immediately she has an offspring. She has to basically wait. Okay. And when the relationship matures and slowly, when the relationship is good, the child, she'll conceive the child, and child is sure to be born in due time. So it is like, so in similar lines, we have come to Krishna consciousness. We have got to know such a big leap we have taken. We have got to know about Krishna. We have got to know about devotional service. We have got to know about the importance of spiritual master. So it is natural. It's a matter of time, actually. It's a matter of time that we will attain perfection. All we have to do is we have to be patient and we have to be determined or confident. So Prabhupada says Nishchaya is confident. And what is confidence? A devotee thinks Avashya Rakhibe Krishna. Krishna will surely protect and give me help for successful execution of devotional service. So in this path of devotional service, when we are rightfully trying to do it, then what happens is there will be obstacles, but we have to understand that Krishna is on our side. We should not think, oh, devotional service, let me have so much of problems, so much of this, because we are trying to go upstream, upstream. So there'll be challenges, there'll be this, there'll be that. And sometimes you may think, let us stop fighting. Like Srila Prabhupada says that, starting devotional service means waging war against Maya. So imagine like a war, with Maya. Okay. So it's a very uneven battle, actually speaking. On one side, we are insignificant, infinitesimal soul, and have been eternally conditioned by Maya. And on the other side, there's Maya herself. So it looks like a very uneven battle. But if we continue fighting in the sense which Maya Devi also wants us to do, if we continue taking shelter of Krishna through continuation of our devotional service, depending on Krishna, then we will never be killed by Maya. Okay, we just continue. And this is the confidence we need to have. Until I keep fighting, I will never be defeated. The moment I give up, at that point, defeat actually begins. Because Krishna will not allow us to get defeated. Okay. So this is, as mentioned, the devotee thinks, which I think you have read this line, right? So similarly in devotional service, similarly in devotional service, surrender means that one has to become confident. Krishna will protect, Krishna will help me. There'll be obstacles, there'll be this, there'll be that, but he's going to help me. And he's there to help me. It's not that I'm alone in this battle. Okay. I'm not alone in this battle. Okay. So in this way, Utsaha Nishchaya and Dhairyat. Srila Prabhupada gives one very nice example of determination. Which is sometimes it is Nishchaya means confidence. Sometimes Prabhupada says determination also. And he says that let's say you are going for hearing a lecture, and and it is on 22nd floor or 20th floor or 15th floor, whatever, like, and then the lift, when we are going, the lift suddenly stops to operate and it becomes dysfunctional. So determination means it doesn't matter, I'll go by stairs. So what does it take obstacles so seriously? One continues with devotional. Sometimes the tendency of the mind is to magnify our own conditionings, obstacles so much. So we should not fall prey to it. The more we give importance to these little things, the more these things will become bigger and more important in our lives. Okay. There will be always some or the other, something will keep coming, keep going, and all those things. But what we try to do is we try to continue our devotional service as nicely as possible. So when a devotee understands feet and earth, head and heart in Golok Vrindavan, after that he continues with devotional service, as we have been discussing, as nicely as possible. So basically, always in the mode of improvement. Okay, always in the mode of improvement. Today I'll try my best. That is mode of improvement. Okay. So, as already explained, one should not be idle, but should be very enthusiastic about executing regulative principles. Tat tat karma pravartana. Neglect of regulative principles will destroy devotional service. Yeah. So this is what I was mentioning. No? This is one of the weed is to breaking the regulative principles. We allow that to increase. The enthusiasm is actually diluted. In this Krishna consciousness movement, there are four basic regulative principles: forbidding illicit sex, meat eating, gambling, and intoxication. A devotee must be very enthusiastic about following these principles. If he becomes slack in following any one of them, his progress will certainly be checked. Srila Rupa Goswami therefore recommends Sattat Karma Pravartana. One must therefore strictly follow the regulative principles of Vaidhi Bhakti. In addition to these four prohibitions, there are positive regulative principles, Niyama. So these are called Yama. Prohibitions and prescriptions are called Niyama, such as daily chanting of 16 rounds on Japamala beads. These regulative activities must be faithfully performed with enthusiasm. So being strict about these regulative principles, not becoming loose about them, not that, no, some allowance, some this, some that, and not thinking it as a burden. If we start taking these regulative principles as burden, then obviously, like, no, it will look like devotional service or Krishna consciousness will start looking like some kind of punishment which we have got in our lives. Willingly, happily. So once I asked Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj, so I should do this because it is the instruction of Shastras, right? So he told, not just that, you understand how it is good for you. Okay. So sometimes when we hear these instructions, regulative principles, we have to follow, we must follow. We may think, oh, so much of regulations. But we also need to understand that they are good for us. How they are good for us? Let us understand that. How these different regulative principles, how they are good for us. If I'm not spending my 2 hours in chanting, what good I'm going to do with those 2 hours? I probably end up spending the same time on some Facebook or this. What are people managing to do actually in those vacant 2 hours? It may be some gossip. There's no productive usage, right? So by Krishna's mercy, we have got an engagement for 2 hours, actually speaking. That we are not getting. So sometimes we may feel hard pressed for time in Grihastha life. Oh, I have to do this. I have to do a job. Kids. 16 rounds. But in one sense, we see that, no, it really helps in one way, because we don't end up wasting our time in something useless, talking or something. There's some social media engagement or some. We are saved from so much of wastage of time and energy. Sometimes I used to think, oh, $16, no, it is now, because I was seeing that nowadays jobs have become, but actually if we see, if there are no $16, then it is so difficult actually. People will invariably be engaged in some nonsense. It's not that they'll use that time even to do something okay, good, it is just wastage of time. So these regulative principles must be faithfully performed. Faith is very important. Faithfully performed with enthusiasm. So we need to have faith in these activities. Okay, that faith that this is good for me. Faith that this is what will please Krishna. Okay. While we are chanting, faith that this holy names are really most merciful. They are person. Harinam Prabhu. We need to have faithful performance of whatever we are doing. Faithfully we do our job. Faithfully we remain in a relationship with our, as a husband or as a wife or as a father. Faithfully doing our roles. If we do everything faithfully, there will be no duplicity. If we are not doing things faithfully, we are inside something, outside something, which is natural for us because that's our problem. Simplicity is a rare virtue of Kali Yuga. So because of lack of simplicity, something, mind is saying something, body is saying, doing something else, words are saying something else. But when we do things faithfully in Krishna service, then we our mind will be fixed on pleasing Krishna. So you see, these are some very important qualities by which we should start assessing our activities, whether I'm doing this activity with faith, whether I'm doing this activity with enthusiasm, whether I'm doing this activity with pleasure. Am I doing it unwillingly or I am doing it willingly? Sometimes unwillingly we chant, right? It's like, okay, somehow we have to do it. So whether I'm doing it with faith, whether doing it with enthusiasm, whether doing it with pleasure. Okay. So in this way, we have to start assessing whatever activities we are doing. Okay. So these regulative activities must be faithfully performed with enthusiasm. This is called tat-tat karma pravartana or varied engagement in devotional service. So sincerity and with faith, with pleasure and with enthusiasm, we should try to do all our activities, whatever we are doing. So then what it leads to? It leads to a state of consciousness which is perfectly poised to think about favorably pleasing Krishna. How can I please Krishna with doing something, let's say my chanting, without any pleasure? Oh, come on, yes, I have to do it. Unwillingly. Or without faith, or without sincerity, or without enthusiasm. We need to do all these things. We need to see, these are the four qualities. This is what Bhakti Rasamrit Maharaj actually says. That any activity has to be done with these four qualities. Faith, enthusiasm, pleasure, sincerity. So this leads to yoga. This is called yogi. If we are able to do all our activities in this state of consciousness, that means we are yogi. Then it is very easy for us to dedicate that activity for the pleasure of Krishna. Again, it's a meditation. It's a cultivation. Someday we'll be falling short. But it is such an interesting homework to do that even if we are, let's say, still we get happiness. And whatever extent we are able to do 1% also, we get happiness. Once Bhakti Gaurav Narayan Maharaj came,